Hello, kiddos. We are back with social studies lesson 5. We started on lesson 5 Friday in class. Sorry, my nose is itching. It's my allergies, fall allergy season. We did one map and we looked at purposes of maps, how to read a map, how to know its purpose, which really means we're reading the map key. We're reading the map title. Don't forget to look at your compass rose on a map. Today we're going to be looking at 3 different maps for today's lesson. Today's lesson is short. Tuesday's lesson will be a lot longer. Wednesday we have a very short quiz. I think it's 5 questions, very short, which sounds good. However, if you miss one question, that means you made an 80% C. So you want to shoot for getting a 5 out of 5. You guys know my opinion on quizzes and tests. I really don't put a lot of points on quizzes. I don't double up the points or anything because I feel like your grade should mostly come from your hard work on day-to-day work. So I'm not going to double the amount of points you get on a quiz. The bulk of your grade is going to come from your daily work for me, okay? So without further ado, let's get into our lessons for the day. Okay. Trying to find them. Okay. Screen. Oop, where did it go? That's not what I'm wanting to see. That's not what I'm wanting to see. Not it. Also not it. Hello, Zoom. Zoom, come in. Okay, here we go. All right, so you're going to download the Canvas from Canvas. This PowerPoint. Okay. So right now I have Canvas. This is the teacher view. This is my my dashboard. This is what it looks like from the teacher side. Okay. This is Miss Daniels. She is my second block. Okay. This is my dashboard for Daniels' classroom. I don't yet have a Zoom pre-recorded lesson link in here for lesson 5 part 2. Because that comes after I make this video, after I do the conversion, after I upload it to YouTube and get a link for it. So that will probably be over here. And then lesson 6 will be over here. And then 7, 8, and 9 will be over here. Okay, those will be for this week's lessons. All right, that'll be before Monday will be lesson 5 part 2, and maybe even lesson 6. Okay. This is what you want to click to get your PowerPoint. This is the PowerPoint that you need for Monday and Tuesday's lessons. Here's the other place you can go, assignments. Okay. I'm going to do something else. I'm going to put this on, and that's a preview of what you're going to be downloading. I'm going to put this, if I can find a little button for it, on student view. I got to move my little Zoom thing. And if you hear background noise, my husband's on a phone call long distance, so he's kind of loud. If you guys haven't heard him yet. And it might be blocking it because of this preview. Normally I can put this on something called student preview where I can see what it would look like for students. I'm not seeing that button right now. Oh, well, I guess I won't see that right now. Okay, so you can find it in assignments. Click assignments. You can click there. Here you can get the same PowerPoint that's at the bottom of my homepage. It's the same thing. Download it. Once you download it, it's going to look like this. What you're seeing on that first screen, this is not quite it. It's a preview, and it's a little bit out of order because it's going to look shorter than what it actually is. It gets stuck on certain pages, and it's missing some pages because it's just a preview, and it's a 61-page PowerPoint in total. And 61 pages is a 7-day document, so it's not that you're doing 61 pages on one day. You're not. Okay, so excuse me, I just had a late dinner. We did population density map Friday. And see, it messes this up, but it looks fine when you actually download it. This is actually where we start our work today. Okay, this is what the document looks like when you download it. Okay, so this is where we start. And if yours is like mine, I have the most up-to-date version of PowerPoint. You're going to want to enable editing, because you need to be able to edit the document. This right here, this is one of the links that I embedded in the document because I paid for all these downloads. And when they sent them to me, they didn't have all the links that you need. So I had to go back to my printed version of these documents and take pictures with my phone of the maps and make new online documents with these maps and embed that back in here. So that took several hours. So you want to click each one of these and you will come up with the map that you need to do your work, because you can't just come up with this stuff out of thin air. I should have just pulled this up right here. Okay, so this is the first map you're going to need. Territorial acquisitions. You're going to have that in order to answer these questions. What would you use the map for? Well, the title helps you. I'm going to dismiss that so it goes away. Territorial acquisitions just means how the different parts of our country came together. Territory means parts that are not yet officially the country. To acquire means to buy or to get. So this is literally pieces of our country coming together to form the United States. It would later be called the United States. Okay. So what could you use this map for? That's what that question's asking. So you're going to put your cursor there and you're going to type in your answer. Does this map show natural or human features? We spoke Friday about natural human features. Natural features would be features that come from the one above, or features that were there that humans didn't create. Mountains, lakes, rivers, continents, we didn't make that. That was there before humans were there. Okay, so those are natural features. Human features, that's things like population, because humans are the population. Buildings, that's a human feature, okay? So is this map that's showing how our country was pieced together? Some of it was from war, some of it was buying big chunks of land from other countries. Look at your image. Did our country come together because it was naturally just there? Did it just fall into the lap of our government officials? Or did people in the government have to work with other humans to gather all this land to make our country? So are these natural features or are these human features? This map, think about it just for a minute. Did humans work together to bring our country together? Or did this land just fall into the hands of the United States? Did it just magically, poof, I declare you United States? Is that what we're seeing here? Okay. Think about your answer, because Friday I saw some pretty crazy answers in students' responses. So use common sense with that question, okay? All right. These two slides, I didn't give you your link twice. So for these, you're going to have to go back to this one, refer back to your map, or just do like me, just keep on going back to that one picture, okay? So this question says, when would this map be useful? Let's look at this. When might you want to use this map? Now, I have the advantage of being able to do this. Pretty cool thing. I love my touchscreen computer. I don't know if all you guys have this, but it's a pretty handy-dandy feature, okay? Territory of the original 13 states. Louisiana Purchase, 1803. This was original 13 states. Great Britain said that it was no longer the UK's land as of 1783. Texas was annexed into United States and away from Spain in 1845. Spain gave this part of Louisiana to the United States in 1819, so they gave that little part of Louisiana to the United States before they gave this up. This had to be fought for. Okay. I don't know why my screen isn't letting me move over like it needs to. Okay. This part of our country, Mexico, gave over. I'm thinking after more battles, but I'm not positive. I'd have to brush up on my history. 1848, this came from Mexico. Spain gave this little piece of Colorado over in 1819, the same time they gave this piece of Louisiana. This came from Mexico in 1853. This part of our country came from a treaty with Great Britain in 1846. This part had originally been part of the United States, but was given back to Great Britain in 1818. And Britain gave us, United States, when I say us, this part of North Dakota and Minnesota and this little corner of South Dakota in 1818. When might this map be useful? Okay. The question's asking, when might this map be useful? And this part of Alaska was purchased from Russia in 1867 and Hawaii 1898. Okay. It's not that Alaska became our 50th state in 1867, but it was purchased, the land itself, from Russia in 1867, became a state many, many years later. But answer those questions in your PowerPoint based on that map. When might this map be useful? Let me give you a hint. Trying to find your way to another state, that's not a correct answer for that question. If you give me the answer, trying to find your way to another state, here, I'm going to mark it wrong because that is not a valid answer. All right. Describe one fact you learned from the map right here. Okay. Remember, you can stop a video so you can type in your answers. All right. Next slide, 41. Slide 41. Based on the map, which of the following cities is the most densely populated city? Wow. That question doesn't fit. I'm going to have to go back and edit that question because that question is fouled up. All right. So I will fix the question for slide 41. Slide 42. Here's a new map. This would be a map of all the counties in the U.S. Look how small some of these counties are. You get over here on the West Coast, on the western half of the U.S., those counties get huge. And for all of us outside Louisiana, we have parishes. The other 49 states have counties, okay? Alaska's counties are huge. And it looks like Hawaii doesn't have any counties. They just have an island. Each island, I guess, is just named for the island. No counties within it. Okay, so Louisiana has parishes. The other 49 states have counties. Well, 48, because Hawaii doesn't have counties. They just have islands. Okay. So this is going to be Tuesday's lesson. So I'll take that back. Tuesday's lesson starts on slide 48. So we're still going. 43 is Monday. So this one, we're going to be comparing precipitation, which is just stuff that falls out of the sky. Water. That could be rainfall, snow, sleet. It's the wet stuff that falls out of the sky. We're comparing precipitation in Nevada and precipitation in Louisiana. Remember I said that the makers of this product fouled up? Well, if you click this link, it's going to take you to, Nope, wrong one. I shut down the link because it was fouled up. Let me show you what it takes you to. Control, there we go. Nope, not what I needed. But I did just find out something. I wish I would have known that earlier. I couldn't figure out how to get a blank slide. Now I did. All right, so they left out a bunch of maps. They wanted you to compare Louisiana to Nevada, but there's something missing here. There's just a map of Louisiana. Kind of hard to compare it to Nevada with no map of Nevada. But we can see this closer that this part of Louisiana gets less rain than this part of Louisiana. And this section of Louisiana gets a lot more rain. And this little section, wow, that is a wet area. That little dot, they get a lot of rain, lots of rain. That little circle gets more rain than surrounding area. And I guess compared to all that, we're the dry area of Louisiana. Never thought of us being a dry area ever. But is it wet in a large area of Louisiana? I mean, that matches up to, they get 60 to 70 inches of rain a year. That's a lot of rain. That's 5 to 6 feet of rain a year that they get in these areas. So I would not want to get 5 to 6 feet of rain there. Okay. So that's Louisiana. Unfortunately, they didn't give us Nevada. So I'm going to blow up Nevada just for a minute so you can see this larger. I'll shrink it back down in just a moment. All right. I know it looks weird because I made it really wide. But do you see anywhere on that map that gets 60 to 70 inches of rain in Nevada? I see one little area over here that gets, it looks like 35 to 40 inches. That one little spot by Lake Tahoe. That's it. The rest of it looks pretty dry. Looks nothing like Louisiana's map. So we're going to be comparing, that went too small, too fast. We're going to be comparing the rainfall in Louisiana to the rainfall in Nevada. Okay, guys? And that one I shall delete. Okay, so I had maps on all these and they're all gone. Yay. All right, so this first box, you're going to type in, what do both of the maps show? So tell me what those two maps show. Don't tell me what one map shows. Tell me what both maps show. All right. Then you're going to type in this box, which state receives the most precipitation? Should be a no-brainer, but give me the right answer. Slide 46. What area receives the least amount of rain out of the two states? So look at that map. Find the area. And remember, if you click on the actual image, you can make this larger, just like I'm doing. Okay? Click on it. What area gets the least amount of rainfall? You might not be looking at a compass rose, but you should remember your directions. North, south, west, east. Remember, you have intermediate directions. Southwest, southeast, northeast, northwest. Okay? Tell me where you, out of those two maps, what area gets the least rainfall? Okay? There's an area that's very obviously drier than the other areas. Very obviously drier. Clearly. No question about it. Okay, guys. Down here, how would you describe the similarities among the two maps? There's obvious similarities. Give me at least one, if not two, ways they're similar. Slide 47. How would you describe the difference in climate between Nevada and Louisiana? So climate is weather over a long period of time. I always tell my students about 100 years. Weather is temperature and amount of rainfall, precipitation. So, how would you describe the difference in climate between Louisiana and climate in Nevada? Okay. Type in your answer. For a final one, this one's going to require just a little bit of thought. It's easy though. Sugarcane likes to grow in a climate that is warm and humid with lots of precipitation. Which state would be the best place to grow sugarcane? Just type in the state. Would Louisiana be better to grow sugarcane? Or would Nevada be better to grow sugarcane? When you finish this, go back up to File, Save As. Save it with whatever title you want to save it with. Perhaps it's your name. Perhaps it's your name plus the 4UI or 4U1. Then upload it back to Canvas. Okay, guys? Get it back up to me on Canvas. Save it back into Canvas for me. Upload it back to me. That's how you're going to get your grade. Clear. As always, you guys can text me, you can Dojo private message me, you can email me, but texting and Dojo messaging will be fastest. I have it set up so that everybody can view my files. Once you download it, then you can edit it. You cannot edit it until you download it to your device. Okay? I have it saved under assignments. I also have it saved under the home page, the picture where you see the ocean view, okay? I'll do another video for Tuesday, but it's the same document. It's the same PowerPoint, okay? See you guys Tuesday. Bye.